Hi everybody, Joey here again and welcome back. So today we're going to talk about how to properly drill a glass aquarium. Now before we get started, we have to first determine if we can even drill that glass aquarium. What I mean by that is the glass that you're drilling going to be tempered or not? Now tempered glass, if you try to drill it, it's going to shatter into a million pieces, whereas regular plate glass or float glass will allow you to drill it. So first and foremost, we have to find out if it's tempered or not. But how are you going to do that? Well, very simple actually. Most aquariums will have a sticker on the bottom of the aquarium that says bottom pane is tempered, do not drill. So obviously we're not going to drill that pane. We know it's tempered. Another option is to simply contact the manufacturer and ask them, based on the aquarium that you have, did they use tempered glass or not? Those two methods are typically the pretty easy methods to do, but if it's an older tank, you don't know who built it, and it doesn't have any stickers, then you're going to have to find out if it's still tempered or not, because you don't want to shatter the glass. So one method of doing so is looking at the glass through a polarized lens. What do I mean by a polarized lens? Well, a lot of sunglasses come with polarized lenses, or in the case that I'm going to show you, 3D glasses that you get at a movie theater for free usually are mostly using polarized lenses. Now what's this going to do? Well, if you look at tempered glass through a polarized lens, what's going to happen is it's going to expose a couple of things. When you look through polarized glass, glasses at a tempered glass, it's going to show black lines or black dots. Now how do you know if your glasses are even polarized? Well, you're going to have to first find a piece of glass that is guaranteed to be tempered. What I suggest doing is go out to a car in your parking lot or use your own car and look through your back windshield. Back windshields as well as front windshields are typically always tempered, but the back windshield is always tempered for sure. On newer cars anyway. If you don't have a car, just go look at somebody else's in the parking lot or on the street, whatever. Anyways, so when you have your glasses and you hold them a few inches away from your face and look at the actual back pane of the window, you'll see what happens. If nothing happens, then you're not using polarized glasses. You'll have to find a pair that are. But using your back windshield is definitely a good test subject to see if the glasses are even polarized in the first place. Once you've figured out that you have polarized glasses and you can tell the difference between tempered and non-tempered, but once you have that, you can now go look at your aquarium and see if it's tempered as well. That's pretty much it. If it's tempered, don't drill it. If it isn't tempered, go ahead and drill it. So to drill a hole in your aquarium, you're going to need a diamond-coated hole saw. They come in various sizes and drill various sized holes, obviously. These are relatively inexpensive, ranging from anywhere from $8 to $15. That will cover almost every size you'd need, anywhere from a half inch to upwards of an inch and a half, 2 inches. Now, what size hole saw will you need for your bulkhead? And what size bulkhead should you be using? Well, the bulkhead is determined by how much water flow you want in your aquarium. Each bulkhead is going to flow a different rate, especially depending on the placement, whether it's in the back wall, on a side wall, or in the base of the aquarium. Now I've created a chart on DIYfishkeepers.com that will show you exactly how much flow a bulkhead will get. Also, a chart on what size hole saw you'll need for what size bulkhead. So now that we know what size bulkhead we need and what size hole saw we need, we can now go ahead and get started with drilling the actual aquarium. So starting out, you're going to want to find out where you want to drill your hole. You're going to place your pattern in place, and using this pattern will actually allow you to mimic that exact same hole on many aquariums. So you can get the exact same height on every aquarium that you drill and exact same placement. So we want to take our gasket and our guide and have it handy. Once you figure out where the hole is going, you're going to take some duct tape and tape it under where that hole is going to be. The reason being is because when you drill that piece of glass out, it has the potential of falling and cracking a pane that's below it. So this piece of duct tape is strong enough to hold that piece of glass from falling and not allow the drill to actually drill through the tape as well. So with both in place and everything clamped down, we can go ahead and pour some water inside of the hole. Now, because we're using a gasket and clamping it in place, the water's not going to go anywhere. It's going to stay in place. Now you can place the actual drill bit inside of the guide and start drilling, starting off slow and holding it level. You don't have to start it off on an angle or anything like that, just hold it level. Go nice and slow at first, and then you can speed it up. Typically speaking, a 6mm glass should only take about 60 seconds or less to drill. Anything thicker, like half inch, which is 12mm, should take no longer than 2 minutes to drill. You'll get used to it as time goes by. You're not applying any pressure, you're just letting the weight of the drill do all of the work. So don't push on it. Eventually, you'll hear the water dripping through the bottom as the glass starts to drill all the way through. Eventually, that glass is going to be falling out, and the tape will catch it. From there, you can wipe everything up with a towel, and your hole is finished. If you notice some sharp edges or anything like that, which you typically shouldn't, you can sand it down with some 60 grit sandpaper or something of the like and make it more soft. From there, you can install your bulkhead. The bulkhead obviously goes with the gasket, goes on the inside of the aquarium. The bulkhead slides in and then screws on. All you're looking to do is hand tighten that, then possibly take a wrench and give it a quarter twist or a half twist. From there, you should be fine. Now, some bulkheads tend to leak constantly, no matter how tight you make them. So what I suggest doing is, instead of having that gasket, if you have a leaky gasket or a leaky bulkhead, you can drain the tank, and instead of using the gasket, use silicone. Silicone the bulkhead right in place. It's not permanent. You can take it off eventually if you needed to, but this is going to be a for sure thing, so it doesn't leak. Anyways, guys, that's how I drill a glass aquarium. I hope you guys found something useful in this video. I definitely want to thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.